another one of them videos. I don't own the rights to this music. In fact, it's the Hamiltons. It's called Alone. You might want to check it out, especially the video. And although this is going to be one of the messages, I want you to check this out. We're still dealing with How Did I Get Here, that series. And the title to this message is Where Is My Love? Again, it's the series of How Did I Get Here, but the title to this one is Where Is My Love? Because there are those that wonder, where's my love? Why come I can't find it? Why do I struggle so much to get it? Some people could care less about it. Some people have given up on it. I'm looking at myself. I know I'm looking a little rough, but I'm out on a job, and I try to give this message at the inspiration of God. You never know where you're at, so I'm not sitting at my desk this time. But let's go over this. The scripture that I want to use, and I'll put it at the bottom, the 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. I think it begins at the 3rd verse. And I'm paraphrasing to a degree, but I'm going to try to get it right. It says, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, who believe not, who the God of this world have blinded the minds of them, lest they should see the glorious light of God, of Christ, which is the image of God. Don't hold me on that. I'm going by memory. I don't have my Bible with me, but I will put the text at the bottom. But the part I want to focus on is gospel is good news, is the truth. And at the end of the day, God is love. And so some of us want to give love and receive love. And so when it says, if our gospel, if our good news, if our love or desire to love or desire to receive love, see, if our gospel be hidden, it is hidden to those who believe not. Some people don't believe that they are worthy of love. Some people don't even know how to love. Some people don't even know what love is. However, it says, but their mind have been blinded. It didn't say they refuse to see. It said they can't see. It says, whom the God of this world, small case G-O-D, which is an idol god, which is Lucifer, which could be your job, which could be your money. It could be your sport. It whatever you worship could very well be blinding you or blinding the person you're trying to love. It could be abuse. It could be being misled, misunderstood. It can be a number of things. But whatever the case may be, these people have been blinded by the God of this world, lest they should see the glorious gospel of Christ. So at the end of the day, they have been blinded to the love of God. So if they can't see how much God loves them, why are you expecting them to see how much you love them? They could be hurt, wounded. They could honestly be lost. They could have been abused so long that they don't believe that love even exists. Something to think about. If our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. If our gospel be hidden, it is hidden from them that are lost. Whom the God of this world has blinded the mind of them, lest they should see the glorious gospel of Christ. Some people can't help it. oftentimes you have to read your own mail. In my experience, I've tried to love people by my companion. As a matter of fact, I learned this lesson recently. I remember saying to her, all I want is you. That's all I want. I don't need no money. I don't need any of that. All I want is you. I thought she was so precious, and she is. But I said, all I want is you. I don't need your skills. I don't need you for your body. I don't need you for what you can do with your body. I want you. Because that's all I wanted to love was her. This ain't no sad story. Because see, in all actuality, people always say, well, what is my ministry? Your misery is your ministry, because that's what you study. And when you get to the point that you want to figure out why something isn't happening, that's why this is titled, Where Is My Love? Okay, so now you have a situation, you telling this person, all I want is you. And then you think about the text, it says that their minds have been blinded. They may not be able to give you what you're looking for. And it could probably frustrate them because they don't know how to give you what you're looking for. Yes, they love you. Yes, they want you. But what you're asking for, they may not be able to give you because they can't find it. How dare you give a person a $100 bill, lay it in the middle of an empty room with no furniture, put a blindfold on them and ask them to give you $100. How hard is that for them to find it? You don't know who moved it. I learned from a preacher years ago, inside of every person is three people. Three people inside of every person. There is the person who you think you are. There is the person who other people think you are. And there is the person who you really are. If you focus on the person who you think you are, you can come off self-centered, arrogant, self-serving, and selfish. Because it's all about you and what you think you deserve and what you want other people to see in you. If you focus on the person who other people think you are, you'll never be satisfied. Because you can never satisfy everybody. You can satisfy eight people and you will consume yourself with the other two. Why the other two wasn't as satisfied as the other eight? Jesus didn't put up with that. Think about it. When he healed the 10 lepers, only one came back to say thank you. He asked them, where are the other nine? The man that got his full healing said, it ain't got nothing to do with me. I'm concerned with me and you, God. I'm not concerned with what the other ones got. Quite frankly, I was never welcome where they're going anyway. So people kill me when you get blessed. Now you want to go a place that you was never welcome or never wanted or never even wanted to go. You just think that you should be where your gift is. No, your gift came to you. Don't take the gift that God gave you and run to where you think the gift was supposed to be. If he wanted the gift there, he would have left the gift there and he would have let you go there. Tell him thank you where you are. Now, some people can't give you something they don't even know where it's at. Because we covered the fact that if you focus on who you think you are, what'll happen. We focused on who other people think you are, what can happen. The only option you have is to find out who you really are. And the only way you can find out who you really are is to find God. Not that he's lost. He's not lost. But you're going to have to get with God to find out what he invested in you. Because God gives you according to your need and his purpose. Find out what God invested in you. And it'll give you a start to finding out who you really are. Because that's where you're going to be most productive. That's where you're going to be most happy. That's where your love is. You want to know where your love is? Go to God. God, what did you make me for? What did you design me for? I know about the gifts that you've given me. I thank you. I'm able to get out here and work. And sometime when I get sick, God bless me with the gift of healing myself and things of that nature. And that's fine. But God, why did you make me? I go through different things, struggles, adversities, but I seem to overcome. God has blessed me to go through things that some people committed suicide. Some people have just lost their minds. Some people lost their hope. I don't know why I didn't. I don't know how I survived the things that I survived, the things that I've had taken from me, the things that I lost. I don't know. All I know is I still have God. And I know that out of those things that I survived, I'm trying to talk to you now to encourage you to know that you can make it through yours. To talk to God to find out, why is it that you allow me to make it through what I made it through? And go from there. My time is up on this particular message. I thank you for yours. God bless you. Continue to be sweet and maintain. And know that God is always in your corner. You got to learn how to love yourself. Oh, that's awesome. Father God, in the name of Jesus, bless anybody that hears this. Bless them to receive what you want them to receive. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And God bless you.